Hello students, previously we have discussed vodka, the process of vodka making and what are various types of vodka and the countries like Russia, Poland which are famous for the production of vodka. So in this session we are going to discuss gin, which is a very important beverage. When we talk about from the examination point of view, a lot of questions comes from gin. So gin was created mainly for a medicinal purpose and its credit goes to the Dutch professor who is known as François de La Beau around 1614 and 1672. He was associated with the discovery of vodka. So he was working on juniper berries and the flavors of juniper berries, and during that process he discovered vodka. Using a distillate from rye, he rectified or redistilled the flavor of juniper berries and perfected it in a form of medicine. It was used as kidney ailment. The medicine was just sold under the name Genévoir, the French word for juniper berries. The English soldiers brought this drink with popular in England. It was then known as Dutch carriage. Soon it was given the name of gin. So that is the history of gin. Now how is it is produced? So the first step is to produce a neutral spirit. And what is a neutral spirit? The spirit which do not have any flavor and any aroma. So it can be produced in a continuous still or a patent still distillation, either from maize or molasses. So for the production of gin, we can use maize or molasses or any other combination of grains that depend from country to country. The next stage is the infusion of botanicals into the neutral spirit. So we will understand how these flavorings are infused in the neutral spirit. So let's understand what are various flavorings that can be used in gin. So the most important is juniper berries. All the gins must contain juniper berries. So that is a critical ingredient in the production process of gin. Apart from juniper berries, there could be various other flavorings. For example, coriander, angelica, cassia bark, orris root, calamus root, orange or lemon peel. So these are different other flavorings that can be used. But the most important is juniper berries, which should always be there in all the gins. So over here you can see angelica is there, juniper berries are there and cassia bark are there. Now how these flavors are to be infused? So for this we have two methods. So one is head mix. So head mix is a traditional system wherein botanicals are distilled with the spirit by enclosing the botanicals in a head, in a mesh, in the neck of the still. Example is Beefeater. So Beefeater is the gin which is made by the process of head mix. So basically all the botanicals are hanged onto the neck of the pot where the neutral spirit is there, and then the neutral spirit is heated and with the vapors will rise and will pass through the botanicals and then will go to the condenser and then again it will convert it in liquid. So that is how the head mix process goes on. The next step method is cold mix. So over here the botanicals are soaked in the spirit then distilled in a pot still to give a strong flavor, later diluted with unflavored neutral spirit until the correct proportion of alcohol and ingredient is achieved. So over here basically all the ingredients are submerged in the neutral spirit and then it is heated, so infusion will happen and that's how the flavors will be extracted into the liquid. So, and the flavorings are to be distilled by pot still distillation. So that is very important. Gin, because it's a rectified spirit and it's a neutral spirit, does not require any maturation. So they are not matured in wooden barrels by the law or by the process itself. Types of gin. There is first important gin is London Dry Gin. It is from England and the mash contains less corn and more barley. So in the United Kingdom area, basically barley is a more prominent grain. So that's why for the production of gin also, they use more barley and less corn. And these gins are of extraordinary smoothness. The gins are distilled at high proof, then redistilled in the presence of juniper berries. So these gins are ideal for drinking straight because they have more flavor and more color. So that's why they are good for drinking straight. And they can be used in various cocktails as well. The production process as follows. Alcoholic wash will be there, and that will go for the process of patent still distillation, and then it will go again for the pot still distillation with the addition of juniper berries. It will be stored in glass lined container because we do not want any color to come to the gin. So that's why they are stored in glass lined containers. And then next is bottling. The second gin is American dry gin. So American gins are usually produced by one of the two methods, that could be head mix or cold mix, and they are also quite famous. Plymouth gin is unsweetened and more pungent than London dry gin. It is a traditional gin of British Navy. It is used in the preparation of pink gin, which is a very famous cocktail. Then comes the sloe gin, and they are flavored with sloe berries. Another important gin is Dutch gin. So Dutch gin is usually begin with a grain mash of equal parts of barley, corn and rye, and they are distilled in pot still distillation at around 100 proof. So the initial distillation is known as malt wine, is then redistilled in the presence of juniper berries in another pot still at a low proof, which carries congeners and produces Dutch gin's full-bodied character. Because of the pot still distillation which happens in the first go and in the second go, these gins will have lots of congeners, and because of congeners, these gins, the body of these types of gin is full-bodied. So that is very important, and because they are full-bodied, they will have complex characters and will have lots of aromas and flavors. So that is very important. And how they are produced? So first we'll have alcoholic wash that will go for pot still distillation, and then again a pot still distillation with the addition of juniper berries, and they will also be stored in glass lined containers as same as the London dry gin, and then they will be bottled. Other flavored gins are Pimm's No. 1, Old Tom, Sloe Gin, Lemon, Orange and Blackcurrant. Some brand names of gins are Gordon's, Gilby's, Beefeater, Tanqueray, Nicholson, Boots, White Satin, House of Lords, and Bordels. And some other brand names are written on the slide. So these are various brand names throughout the world which are famous in the production of gin. Some images are over here. In the next session, we will talk about brandy, which is a very famous beverage from the region of Europe, particularly from France, Italy. So these are the areas where brandy is popular, and we'll discuss all about brandy. Now, what are required as an ingredient for the production of brandy, and then how it is produced, and what are the different properties of brandy. So that's what will be there in the next session. So be regular on the channel, and you will get latest updates about new topics. Thank you.